Hey guys, my name is Robert. A few months ago, I shared with you PasteFlow. And PasteFlow is a paste stack for Alfred. Basically, it's a list that, as you can see right now, is empty, where you can select text and pin it in there. So right now, I have the three different lines of text. And once they are in there, you can paste them individually. You can paste them all at once. You can paste them in reverse. You can paste them individually in reverse. And this is something that I showed you in the last video. I went over the setup of the workflow. But right now, I have prepared a big release, and I wanted to explain to you how now you will be able to do this, not only with plain text as before, but also with rich text, with files, with images, and with different kinds of clipboard data. Before I go into that, I wanted to tell you that some weeks ago, I also added the ability to add items manually. So if you're in the main menu and you type add like this, you have this option. And you can also access it with a hotkey. And something that I found after I added this feature is that it's a great way to empty thoughts whenever you are working on something else. So I may be working on a project and then suddenly I just think of something. And then I just had a brilliant idea. How about this or that? And then this goes in there. And I continue working on something. I continue typing something else. And then a little bit later, I have another idea. Actually, that sounds really cool. And then I type it in there and I continue working on something. And then a little bit later, whenever I want to stand up and stretch or go grab lunch or something, I will open an empty note and I will just paste those ideas that I had during the time that I was working on something else. And I figure out this is just a great way to have like a quick inbox that is very minimal and not distracting at all. That was something that I wanted to mention. Another thing is that several users have been emailing me because they are so confused when they open the workflow and they find so many different hotkeys. If you are a basic user, probably the only ones that you need from all of this are the green ones, which is the add items, paste the next item, copy the next item, and maybe the one from the main menu. Everything can be controlled from the main menu. But if you really, really want to make the most of this workflow, even all of these hotkeys will not be enough, believe me. And that is why I highly suggest that if you want to really, really use this as a power user, you learn how to use the external trigger. And there is this sample code here. Let me copy it. And in the documentation over in GitHub, there's many different parameters that tell you how to do stuff with that external trigger. So for example, the most basic ones to add stuff to your list is this one, add current clip. And if you want to actually press Command C before, you can add this. And this is a great opportunity for you to start experimenting with creating Alfred workflows. Let's make a blank one here. Blank workflow. PasteFlow triggers. And as a trigger, let's say hotkey, and then let's set Command Option F. And then as an action, we want run script, Apple script. And here you will put the code that you grabbed from the sample is this one. Okay. And here where it says with argument, we will put one of these arguments. All the different actions that you can perform with PasteFlow are here. So the one I grabbed was add current clip. And I told you that will add the item that you have on your clipboard. But if you want to press Command C before that, we will add this C and exclamation mark. Save, and then we simply connect these two, and that's it. Let me empty my list. It's empty. Now I will go somewhere and then press Command Option F. There we go. So it works. Of course, that one is the most basic one, but you have the option of copy the next item, paste the entire stack, copy stack, and not only that, but you have also all the different combinations, because you can invert the order, you can clear the list before doing one of the actions. So I highly suggest that you read this area in the documentation, because this is really what will give you the most flexibility. Something that I am adding in this new release is the ability to set custom sounds per action. And this is something that the users that use the external trigger will be able to take advantage of. With this, you can set not only one argument, but multiple ones. And the fifth argument, if you put a number between 1 and 9, is a custom sound. So let's say the second argument is nothing, third argument, nothing, fourth argument. Now the fifth argument, let's say 5. And this sound will actually replace the default one. And now let's go somewhere. And then again, let's press Command Option F. Then you should be hearing something else. Now, about the new feature of adding files. In a similar way as before, you can select different files. And here they are all images. You can trigger the Alfred action. And then if you go to PasteFlow, you can add everything as a group. And if you do that, everything will go inside one line. But if you decide to add them individually, this will also split everything into different files in a similar way as we were splitting a group of lines into separate different items. And again, there's hotkeys for that. There's an external trigger for that. Actually, it's exactly the same as if you were adding text, at least for this. Now I can go here to my note and I can paste them one by one. This behaves very similar to when we were dealing with text. The cool thing is that now you also have the option of, and here let's go to view. You have this text view. Now you have all the different images that you have there, if they are images. If you only have files, you will not see a preview, of course. Another thing that I wanted to mention in this new feature of adding files is that if you have your list here, and if you want to edit the item, you will not be editing the content of the image or the file, of course, but you can set a unique name. And in this way, you have like a way of identifying different things. And if you see everything in this view, you will have the unique name under the item. An interesting use case is that, for example, you can go online and look for different images. And if you have something like Dropover, that I made another video about it before, it's like this temporary shelf that you can place some images there. You can now copy the subject, and now I just added that to my stack. Let me put this in a shelf. Let me copy the subject. Let me open another one. Let's do the same, drop over, quick look, copy subject. And now if you go to any other application, and for example, this is an application that I have been enjoying recently. It's called Bananotate for Annotations. And here I have the three images that I grabbed online. And here I can just paste them one by one. And of course here, since I'm already in the annotation application, I can be explaining stuff. It's super handy, super fun. I think it's a very cool way to grab images from online that you can use in Photoshop or in other designing applications. You can even go, of course, to a folder, and let me make a new folder here, and you can paste all your list and it will go as multiple files. So it just opens so many other possibilities. This looks very simple, but actually it was lots of trouble to implement. And I learned a lot about how the clipboard works and different file types and all that. It's super confusing. But something that I discovered along the way while I was trying to incorporate the ability of pinning files and images is Alfred's clipboard doesn't save rich text. But what Alfred allows you to do is to create a snapshot of your current clipboard, and later you can restore this snapshot. The way to add rich text to your list will not be the same one as adding normal text or adding files. But for example, I select something here, and then I go to PasteFlow, we have the option of add as rich text. Now this one is in italics, PasteFlow, add as rich text. And if I want, I also can do that with a hotkey. And then I go back to Bear, and Bear, for example, can interpret rich text. Not every application can do that. And here again, I can paste, and now I have some text in bold, my text in italics, and my text together with my image. It's really cool, especially once you learn what's happening behind the scenes. There's some limitations. With rich text, you cannot paste the entire list at once. You cannot merge it. You cannot split like I was doing with multiple files or with multiple lines of text. But what you get in return is a way to also create snapshots of your current clipboard. This is very, very powerful for users that deal with design or with video editing, because you can be inside something like this and let's add some color adjustments. Let's say that I want to make this dark or, I don't know, something. And then here, I will, for example, copy this layer. With this new option that you have in PasteFlow, you can go to the main menu and we have this add current clipboard as raw data. Now we have this with a timestamp. And again, you can edit the name. Let's call it color adjustments. So I can delete all of these. Let's grab this one. Let's go back to the application. I paste this here. And now I can go to my list in PasteFlow and I can paste the color adjustments that I copied before. And as you can see, all of these settings are here. This is super powerful, guys. You have no idea. You can copy layers in Final Cut Pro. You can copy color grades. You can copy objects, graphics, and do something else and later come back and restore them. And you don't have to paste automatically. Remember, you can always, of course, if you press Command, you will copy the items. I know that this may be very niche or just for a very specific target group, but for me, this utility right now is a dream. It really is a total dream, and I use it all the time. Not only I use it as a paste tag, but I also use it as a way to empty ideas, like I was telling you. I also use it whenever I'm working on something and I know that I have something on my clipboard that is important, but I also see something that I want to copy. So I will add whatever I have on my clipboard to my paste tag, and then I can restore it later. So it's kind of like a secondary clipboard. Super useful, super useful. It really has so many different use cases. I just hope that some of you will also find this useful. If you have any question or if you have any more feature requests or any comments that you would like to give me about this, I am more than happy to listen. As always, be sure to follow on my newsletter for more updates on what I'm up to or projects that I'm working on or films that I can recommend and stuff like that. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you soon.